Welcome back to Pathologic. It's currently about 9 in the morning on day 10. I've got three things to do at the moment. The most important thing is to track down Peter Stamaton, who's currently being hunted down by the military. And I think he's probably here. He's supposed to be at the ruins at the center of town, and even though these ruins aren't exactly at the center of town, I think they're the most center, I guess. That's where I'm going to search for him at first, anyway. Second thing I need to do is speak with Mark Immortel at the theater about the whole bull impaled thing, and the person trying to incite a riot that was happening around here, where I saw the woman getting burned earlier on in the game. And I also need to speak with Ruben at the Prosecutorium about Simon Kane supposedly still being alive. At least that's what Katerina says. So first thing, let's go try to track down Peter Stamaton. Oh, and just a quick mention, my stats are all doing very well except for hunger, so I definitely need some food soon. But for now, I can just ignore that, I think. Also gotta remember that my reputation is pretty good right now, but it could do with a little bit of improving, so if I see anybody who's bad, I should probably shoot them just to get my reputation up. God, there's so many gunshots, it's really disturbing. It's unnerving. I feel like ducking each time I hear a gunshot, like they might be shooting at me. Ooh. Oh god, there's two. Okay, Peter Stamaton, are you here? Let's go check. Well, can't get in that way. Oh yeah, where's the nearest food place too? I don't need to focus on that right now, but if I'm gonna go buy it, I should probably just stop at them. There's one here and one here. I'll go to those later. Oh god, fuck! Those are so hard to avoid sometimes. What did that do to my infection? Did it affect my infection? Because my infection looks about the same, actually. My immunity was almost maxed, so I guess mostly what it did was take down my immunity, I think. Not that big of a deal. Okay, I think there was maybe a little entrance around here. Over this way. Oh, no, that's not. Son of a... How do I get in there? I think there's only one entrance and there's just freaking fire in the way. This stupid rat is gonna drive me crazy, hold on. Okay. I see you in there. So I think I should get in there and talk with him. Can I, like, do some platforming? Oh my god, can I? Can I actually do this? Oh, whoa. There we go. Question is, how am I gonna get out of here? Hey, it's Peter! He's just in a disguise. Send me the dark blue flame. I desire to burn down, not in earthly, but in heavenly fire. So please, do bring me this spicy spirit. I'm sorry, I can't read that with a straight face. Bring me my smoky, dense, odorous sap. I want to burn myself in twirine. Spicy spirit, I just can't take that seriously. You look like hell, mate. So you've changed your mind and become the master of cremations after all? Is this how you want to die? Silence! Listen to my confession. I'd rather confess to you than to her. Listen, and I shall tell you of what I had managed to create. When I studied architecture, for the longest time, I remained passive and didn't do or make anything at all, except observations. It always seemed to me that any house is so much more than walls, a hearth, and a roof. I'm listening. At last I realized that any building is an edifice, a concurrence of planes, lines, rhythms, and temperatures that can become a perfect vessel for a soul. Not a human soul, no. A bigger one. The soul that no man can communicate with yet, for it has no shape, cycle, or voice. Are you referring to an intelligent being? I don't know. Neither did I know or experience this soul back then. I only sensed its existence and loved it in advance. When my passion reached its zenith, I realized I just couldn't live like that any longer. I wanted to speak its tongue. I wanted to touch it. Go on, go on. And so I gradually began to try. I started to design buildings that were not buildings. Chambers that people couldn't live in. Everyone thought I was either a madman or a joke. Only my brother believed in me. He and the few that were privy to my secret. They knew that my designs were not intended for men, but rather for this wondrous soul. And what came out of that? Finally, I understood that I was on the right track. I knew I've discovered an insane, but genuine feature that only a lover can feel. And I knew I was striking true. I constructed project after project, but all of them contravened the laws of earthly physics and geometry. Seems like my beloved soul was unlikely to find a permanent shelter on this earth. Why? Chimeras. There were all chimeras. Nobody would have allowed me to even model them. If not for Nina the Wild. Oh, that's when my brother and I met her. She married Victor, went to live here, and provided me with everything. The place, the materials, the working hands, and, most importantly, the hearts willing to believe in miracles. What do you mean? I mean that buildings demand people. Moreover, they demand the people that would demand those buildings back. Museum showpieces, models, abstractions, mind games. These are all not my cup of twine. Nina gave me a whole living town. A town aching and craving to go heavenwards, to the stars. A town desperately hungering for a crown. The crown I've given to it. Oh, this is quite a special town. I guess if there's any place where you could create a building of miracles, this would be it. Is that so? I've built it from prisms and mirrors. I've managed to focus them, to capture the perfect trick of the light and dream. That's right. I'm a trick master, the ultimate magician. I focus the aura of magic, just like a lens focuses sun rays. And now the town is dying, poisoning my precious wreath, my crystal bud, my focus. So what can your polyhedron really do? I cannot put it into words. It's only been tested by the children yet. If you ask them, they tell you that it brings their dreams to life, plays their games, daydreams with them, transports them into someone else's fantasies. Heard anything about it? I have. But the Canes could tell you even more. They tell you this is a vessel that can hold the most precious substance of all, the focus of a soul. But even they cannot understand what they've been granted. Neither can I. And I will never be able to repeat it. I'm dead. You're dead. What? You're not dead yet. I guess he means that he's a dead man walking, basically. Well, this does match with what the Canes have told me about. There being a focus and about... Oh god, what have they even said? I know they've mentioned the focus and... Wasn't someone's soul in the focus and... Cain's, like, Simon Cain's soul took over the... I thought, like, Maria Cain's, like, mother or something? Her, like, soul was taken over? Or, like, dumped out of the focus and Simon Kane took her place, or I remember something about that vaguely. But yes, this is the focus that they're talking about, the one created by the polyhedron? Is the focus in the polyhedron, or is the focus created by the polyhedron? Not quite sure. So this is suicide? It is. See? I was smart enough to take the designs of my creation to the parting. Give them to me, as a keepsake. Old boy. I'm thirsty, old boy. Bring me 5 bottles of Twirine, and you can have the designs. No one would be able to decipher them anyway. And if they do, no one would build it. That's a lot of Twirine. Why do you need that many? I'm not planning to drink them. I need them for self-immolation. Go, go. I'll wait for you. Burning Twirineless is frightening. Its vapors would exalt me to subtle planes. I'd be a mere pile of ash falling to the ground otherwise. I'd just feed the earth, as the steppe people say. It'd gag anyway. Oh my god. Okay, so just leaving aside the fact that he's planning on burning himself alive, which is very disturbing, it's pretty amazing that this game can make this person talking about burning themselves alive so kind of poetic and just deep. Not only are they want to burn themselves alive, but the idea of burning themselves with anything but Twirine is frightening because its vapors would exalt me to subtle planes. So if they don't burn themselves with Twirine, they're going to end up... Their spirit or something is going to end up in bad places, I guess? Somewhere where they don't want to be? And also, if they did that, their ashes would just feed the earth, but the earth would gag at the ashes? That is... Ugh. That is really disturbing, but also amazingly poetic for somebody talking about burning themselves alive. Oh, damn you to hell. Just don't do anything stupid. I'll have another word with you later. Isn't Peter Stampton one of my adherents that I need to protect? He is. I can't let him burn himself to death. So what does the quest say? Peter has requested 5 bottles of Twirine. With these, he plans to kill himself. His request, however, provides me with much-needed time to delay. The main thing, of course, is to prevent him from burning his designs. Yep, so I have the whole rest of the day, I guess. But the whole rest of the day to do what? Don't really know. I guess I'll just do the side quests and hopefully something will pop up. I don't think this is gonna go anywhere. No. Didn't think so. Okay, well, that's that for now. Now I just need to find a way out of here without walking through the flame. How do I leave here without either falling to my death or walking through the flame? Can I, like, jump over to a thing? There's something up here, right? I think I've been up here a long time ago. Nope. So creepy. Crying children. At the top of an impossible structure. Okay, can I jump over the fence from here? I don't think you can jump very far. I don't think I'd make it. I think I would just fall on the ground. But let's try it. Okay, I died. God. The bachelor's legs must be exceptionally weak. I just fell like 6 feet. And I went from almost max health to dead. Bachelor needs to take more calcium. He's got brittle bones. I guess I'll just walk through the flame? I don't think I really have another choice. Unless I can... I don't know, jump up on one of these pillars? Doesn't seem like it. There's like invisible barriers around here. Yeah, I catch a bump on that. Can I crouch through that? I think I have to go through the flame. Let's hope it doesn't hurt too much. Here we go. Oh. Are you kidding me? You can walk around that? Oh my god. That did... Oh. Wait, what? Wait, so did I not take damage the first time, or did I take damage but I just didn't hear it? I'm very confused. I don't know what just happened. I was gonna say, it didn't look like you can walk around the flame. Maybe you can't, though. Let's check. So, health is almost full. It's right there. Now what's it at? I don't think I got damaged. Okay, that's weird. Alright, side quest time. Let's go talk to Mark Immortel and stop by the food shop along the way right here. Should I be buying Twirine along the way? I probably should. I think Twirine I can get from the bar. That might be the only place I can get it, actually. Ooh. Let's kill this guy for the cred. As always, let's check for bandages and children to trade with and stuff. How's my reputation doing? Pretty good. Probably two more people. Killing two more people, I think, would probably get it to max. No food! Uh-oh. That's not a good sign. Thieves over there. Let's help the guard out. Oh my god, are you serious? I just tried to kill two thieves at the same time and I accidentally shot past both of their heads and headshotted a guard standing like 100 feet away. Oh my god. Wow. I was trying to save ammo, because the shots seemed to travel through enemies, so I could do damage to both at the same time, but what a fail. Oh. One more try. Reputation almost maxed. Okay, I think one more will max it. Let's see what Mark has to say about the strange play being put on over there, trying to incite a riot.
Our delusionment is often a delight to both our friends and enemies.
I've been to the lot. Did you see it? Was it impressive? No, the set is too poor. Although the beast is real, I've checked. First of all, I have to confess that this is not my handiwork. On the contrary, it's a direct attack on my interests. It never even occurred to me that this could make an impression on you, let alone a positive one. But I wanted you to see how impressed the mob is. There are several people there, each of them so noisy you could take them for a dozen. Well, yes. You see, the place and the representation are tailored to excite the crowd. Seems like someone wants to gather a mob. And those who gather mobs only do it with a single purpose. They seek to set them onto someone. So who is the target? I think the Canes are. Actually, I don't care in the slightest. But you should. You're now at a time point when you cannot afford to not care. You've only got a day and a half left. I want that thing to end because I don't like their style. What about you? I do indeed care. It's dangerous. But how can they be removed from there? The army seems to be the most convenient means to any end these days. Indeed, a truly smart decision. And kind of elegant, too. It's a professional prejudice of mine. I've never viewed an armed crowd as a tool. I, the master of manipulation. You can simply say it's a sanitary hazard, and it will be burned. Although I'm afraid that won't be the end of it. I'm sure not. I'm sure whoever started that whole farce to begin with and wanted to set them onto the Canes is going to try something else, probably tomorrow. We'll see. The military are now the only real authority in the town. Let them handle the riotous masses, then. All right. Sounds good to me. Let's see what's happened with the quest. Seems that someone is planning to use this as a decoy to cover up their own escape and to lay a blow on the Canes, whom they must be in some ideological conflict with. This is when the soldiers come into play. This incited crowd should be burned down. The sooner the better. Ugh. I feel like that's going to be quite literal, like the soldiers are just going to burn the entire crowd, which is not exactly what I want. I feel like if the key person, the one who's inciting the crowd, the guy in the center, I feel like if he is dealt with in some way, whether it be by killing him or simply arresting him or something, I feel like once he's out of the picture, the crowd will probably disperse. So I hope they don't literally burn everybody. But, I mean, it's the military, I don't exactly expect them to be subtle. Makes me wonder if just shooting the head person is perhaps the best thing to do. But, the quest says to tell the military about it, so I guess I'll do that. Okay, next stop, Reuben. Yeah, I must go speak with Reuben about Simon Kane. Anywhere else to stop along the way? Don't think so. I'm so close to the military, though. And there's a food store right here, so you know what? I'm actually just gonna go tell Block about it. And let me just make sure real quick that medical stores don't sell Twirine. Because I don't think they do, I think it's only the bar that does. Yeah, they don't. Okay. If I actually need 5 Twirine, I feel like that's going to be a big issue, because I doubt the bar sells 5. And if they don't sell 5, then where the heck am I going to get the other ones? Raiding random houses and hoping I find Twirine? That'd be quite a long shot.
The Inquisitor and I haven't held council, even though it's against the rules. I place my trust in the doctors.
Say, Commander, can I come to you in case of an emergency? I sincerely hope you can. I have to admit, I'm furious. The directive I received from the top brass gave me very broad authority and the right to make strategic decisions. It made no mention of an Inquisitor. And now this. What? That is still unresolved. For many years now, it has been an unspoken rule for military command to obey the decisions of an inquisitor. The justification was that an inquisitor would find a way to make a soldier obey their will anyway, whether the latter knows it or not. What is the scope of your duties? I'm responsible for ensuring that the epidemic never spreads from here further. I'm also responsible for the lives of my men. That is what I know for a fact. Your flamethrower cores are burning out everything infected, whether it moves or not. Is that within the scope of their jurisdiction? Absolutely. Well, there's many interesting things for them to see on the bone steak lot. I'd lead them in that particular direction if I were you. Here's what I'll do. I'll notify Longen. He's a stalwart officer, a heart burning with passion. He is in command of the flamethrower corps. I still don't know if that's supposed to be pronounced corps or corpse or what. I forget. He was assigned to my unit right before this whole affair, so let him perform his duty. As for me, spare me any further details. Very well, now I can be at ease. Wait, so do I need to go tell Longen, or is it dealt with? The dying bull was destroyed by the soldiers, there will be no riots. Okay. I guess it's done. That feels way too easy, though. I feel like something's gonna happen. Something bad's gonna happen. Okay, to the food store. If this one has literally no food, then I'm gonna start to get really worried that this town is just, like, out of food. Please have food. That's it? Milk? Ugh. Clear ichor, dark clots in the milk. That just sounds disgusting. I think if you drink milk, it might slightly increase your infection or something like that, too. I know some foods do that. Oh, but given the lack of food, do I really have a choice? I don't think so. I'll take it. The idea of drinking milk filled with, like, blood clots or something makes me want to vomit. It's so fucking disgusting. Oh, right, I've got crackers. They don't do much, but might as well eat them. Ugh. I might have taken down my immunity, actually. I'm not sure. Okay, well, my hunger's not terrible now. It's at least off the screen. Ooh, bad guy. Let's max our reputation here. I think that'll do it. It's not quite maxed. There's a couple pixels there, but it's basically maxed. Okay. So that's dealt with. Now I need to speak with Reuben. Yeah, let's just go straight there. Seriously, need to find children to trade with. I need Meridorm and stuff. Because I have, I think, literally no pain medication. I know I have antibiotics. I might be out of stuff to increase my immunity, but I'm definitely out of painkillers. Wasn't there a guy walking in the street right here? I feel like I just looked away, looked back, and then somebody disappeared. Weird. Food store. I forgot that there was actually a food store here. Oh god. Oh, thank god. Okay. Bread? Definitely. Fresh meat? No. I'll take the dried stuff, not the fresh stuff. Okay. Hunger's at like 20% now. Much better. Don't need to worry about food for the rest of the day. I'm guessing the children are only in places that aren't... Obviously, they're not infected, but I think the children seem to avoid places that were just infected, these dark zones. So I think the children are only in the completely uncolored zones. Which means there are barely any children. I don't think children hang around this, like, warehouse district anyways. I'm pretty sure the only children on the entire map, I guess, are probably up here. And maybe down here. Or maybe just all the freaking children have just, like, retreated to the polyhedron. I don't know. Oh no, they do hang out in the warehouse district? I thought they didn't. I don't know, I'm not gonna complain. Ammo. How much rifle ammo do I have? 12 shots? I guess I'll take more. What does that cost? 2? Thank you. Is this Ruben's Proscatorium? No. This is Ruben's Proscatorium. There you are, old friend.
Yes?
They let me go. But it can't be. Georgie was supposed to put me to death. Why would he have put you to death? Why, blasphemy, of course. Or do you still not realize the fate that befell Simon? Well, I mean, I thought he died, but... let's just get to the bottom of this. Tell me the truth, Reuben. Is Simon alive? What do you mean? Simon is dead. Certainly dead now. Although he was alive. For all the while, he was thought to be dead. Wait, are you saying he was alive during the time he was thought to be dead? Or... Either way, he's saying that he's dead now. Hmm. Katerina Sabarova came back from another sojourn with the spirits and declared that Simon has arisen in the crucible. Just now. She's hysterical. Hmm. Well, Katerina is... That Clara did something to her. Took her power and her crown as a mistress. Are you certain that she said that? It's impossible. I broke Simon down into tiny particles with my own hands, and turned him into the white vaccine. How are you certain that the man whose body you took was Simon Kane? You think I don't know what Simon looked like? You think his greatness, his noble visage, is comparable to his brother or anyone else? After all, if it wasn't his superhuman blood, who else's could fight the disease for so long and almost beat it, even if at the cost of lethargy? Whose? Can you tell me? Understand that in all my time here, I have never, not even once, seen Simon, the only man I hope to meet here. I never saw him alive, never saw him dead. What do you expect me to believe? Fine. Ask at the crucible. Since they let me go, they clearly don't think of me as either a murderer or as a blasphemer. Let them explain where Simon is. I've said all I can. By the name of your master, Reuben, answer me. Did you tell the truth? It's all true. I broke Simon down into particles. Anything that couldn't be used to make the vaccine, I burned. There's no mistake. Can't you see? Only that wondrous organism could produce the white vaccine, the one that's still keeping hundreds of people alive. I give you my word. Very well. Then my path takes me to the Crucible once again, just as 9 days ago, when your master directed me there. So which of the three houses is Simon's? I should probably check them all, but I'll start at Maria's. I have a feeling she may prepare me for what I'm about to see in the other two. Hmm? What's about to happen? Is there anything else to talk about?
Time is of the essence.
Nope. And what's happened with the quest? Reuben gave me his word that Simon Kane no longer exists. He claims to have burnt every particle of Simon's body that was not processed to create the vaccine. In this case, the answer is to be found in the Crucible. Let the Kanes themselves explain what is going on there. Before I head there, let's take a stop by Bad Grief's lair and see if he sells any Twirine. Doing your own private little mime show, Bad Grief?
So, Reuben is alive. I thought him dead.
Of course he sells 4 and not 5. Oh my god, this game is such a dick sometimes. They knew, they did that on purpose. I have no doubt. And I bet you I'm gonna need to buy every single one of these, so I'm just gonna preemptively buy them. Although, that is actually gonna cost me... Well... I'm still gonna have 11,000 left, that's plenty, right? And, oh yeah, you know what, I still have like... 3 rifles to sell, don't I? Yeah, and look at what these sell for, like 4,500 and stuff. Yeah, so that's no big deal whatsoever. Let's go ahead and do that, Hold on a second. Let's do some inventory management here. Let's sell the one that's most used, 82%, yeah. So I'm gonna sell the 82% one and one of the 100% ones, and just save one of the 100% ones for myself.
Where there's kit.
So I'll take all the Twirine. You can have my 82%er and 100%, and I'm still gonna gain money. Sweet. Anything else I want? I could buy boots for 32,000. That sounds like such a great deal, but I'm afraid I'm gonna have to pass up on that deal. I'm sorry. Okay. Is this thing loaded? I guess not. Pay a visit to the Kanes, ask them about the Crucible. Okay, that'll definitely get my reputation up to 100%, yes. Bandages, finally! They seem so rare. I'm gonna go around. I should probably be helping these people. I'm sorry. Whoa! What the? Oh, that scared me. I think I must have gotten a knife thrown in my face. Because I'm pretty sure I was nearly max health. Oh my god. I saved, like, 500 milliseconds before dying. I'll be right back. Okay, let's try this again.
There's more life in me that can be lived.
Actually, there was no reason for you to come and see me today, for I am a chrysalis. Maria? Answer me, Maria. Are you aware that I have always been completely honest with you? I am N. Daniel? You are a man of honor. What is the N? Maria? Tell me, Maria. Have you always been frank with me? You are the only person I've always been frank with, N. Daniel. This is probably because our meeting was so strange, and we've spent too little time together. You are the only one I've always been honest with. And I will keep being honest with you, N. Daniel. I don't want to lie to you. Maria, tell me. Is it true that Simon is alive? Not quite. It's complicated. But you're not going to believe me anyway. It's a pity that you've come to know our family at this horrible time. None of us is in tune with their true nature these days. Hopefully you haven't yet haven't been to the right wing. The wing where my father used to live. What's going on with you all, Maria? Mysticism. I can only tell you that you should trust us. But if you'd rather abandon us now and go over to the winner's side, then you should leave, rather than watch us perish. Katerina is preparing an attack on you. She will use the imaginary murder of Simon to claim that your family is who stands behind the plague. Our family is staring it in the face. The plague is an attack on us. It was us, not anyone else, who could have become its main victims. You will see. Katerina already has, which is why she's running rampant. She's already lost her power. She has transferred it to someone else. And I don't mean Clara. Then who did she transfer it to? Katerina is also planning to seek the Inquisitor's support, and a trial for you. We are innocent before our town. Nobody has ever done so much for the people as we have. Just wait some more until I awaken, and I shall explain it to you. I need explanations now. The accusations your family is facing are too grave. All right. Talk to my dear... to my father. Just don't be surprised by anything. And do not ask unnecessary questions. He's a bit out of it. But they can... he can offer good advice. My dear... she was gonna say something else. My dear something, and then she changed it to my father. And then, they can. They? He's a bit out of it. They can? Who's they? They're not talking just about their father. Are they talking about a mix of their father and, what, their mother? Or Simon? Or what? Fine. I'll do just that. Well, he seems rather normal. I was expecting to come in and see some sort of ritual being prepared. Perhaps candles all over the place and the entire room's transformed, but everything looks normal. Either way, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm gonna speak with Victor and see what he can tell me about what's going on with the Canes.